everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. We've put it off long enough. We have to do a Maggie run, I think. Yeah, Judas has a little bit more... Oh, no, sorry. Judas has the same, but we recently played as him, and I think we lost. Blue Baby has the boss rush, at least. It's either Eve or, Maggie, and we played as Eve semi-recently. Had a great run last time. I really enjoy these Eden runs, and I got so many tokens stacked up. It feels good. Can't wait till we get 69 of those. But let's play as Maggie. So as Maggie, we could, it's the same thing as that Eden run we just had. Actually, no, it's not. Whoa, this is one heck of a room. It's not, but we can choose... Oh, fuck, Curse of the Blind. Technology 2, okay, I'm happy. There's so many cool synergies here. I'm already getting out of sorts, don't worry about it, my brain sorts itself out. Just gotta work the juices through. I'll get that mouse pointer off the screen for you. What am I trying to say? Well, as Maggie, we're actually... spoiled by the fact that I'm so shitty with Maggie, or I've had shitty runs with Maggie at least. Because we've done so poorly, we can afford to, it's basically, you know, player's choice. Do we want to go and fight the lamb? Do we want to go and fight Isaac? We'll make that decision when we come to it. If we're a little weaker, if we're assuming we're still alive by that point, if we're a little weaker, we'll go fight Isaac. If we're very strong, we'll go try to fight the lamb. And if we're fast enough, we totally could do a boss rush mode on this run because we have not done it with Maggie yet. Now, Technology 2 is great. I love it. Obviously does lower the individual damage a little bit. Per second, I think it raises it. But it's also the fact that it hits multiple enemies at the same time. Synergizes so nicely with a wide variety of items as well. But Technology 2 plus Cube of Meat is not giving me a whole lot of confidence for beating the run quickly. But it feels pretty good thus far, nonetheless. I wonder what it could be. It was Cube of Meat. That's alright, it could have been the bandages as well, that's fair. Alright, first floor, actually, you know what, the first floor was done pretty quickly, so maybe I don't know what the F I'm talking about. Boss Trap Room might be feasible, but this is really where we start trying to take Maggie's extra HP and turn it into some Deal with the Devil shenanigans here. Really wish Technology 2 went over those rocks. Or through those rocks. I don't really care what relationship it has to those rocks as long as it doesn't get blocked by them. Yeah, okay. We have no keys and no bombs. Hopefully that changes on this floor as well. Because I would really like to access our item rooms and our shops. I found, and you may disagree, but I found that item rooms and shops tend to be some of the most important rooms to go to in Isaac if you're looking to improve your run. Just saying. No, that's not it, unfortunately. How about here? Yes, so we might be able to bomb our way into... Ooh, it's a 1-up. Might be able to bomb our way into our boss trap room. If we just get one more bomb. At least that gives us, like, one out to get something. Okay. For right now, though, I'm still pretty disappointed. I would be so... Oh, that sucks. I would be super mad if we left this floor without being able to open either of those rooms, though. Come on. Okay, well, that's a staggering amount of money. I'll take it. There's actually a tinted rock right here. And we've got enough bombs that we can blow up the tinted rock and maybe get into that boss trap room as well. Took out a spirit heart. See if we get our deal with the devil first, because we have to be close to our boss room. And it is right there, obviously, now. I think we'll... I mean, we could blow up these pots and try to get something, but usually out of pots you only get money, so who cares, right? Fistula. Wow, this is new. We're not fighting Monstro, which is a bit of a rarity. Are you sure you're feeling okay, game? In theory, Fistula should be a pretty easy boss for us because we have these effectively piercing shots. In practice, it might prove to be a little bit more tricky than that just because of the fact that there's so much shit on the screen. And that's pretty much what just happened right there. But as long as we don't take two more hits of damage, we should be able to have at least a chance at a deal with the devil. I don't know if the mechanics are exactly the same as they are in vanilla. We did take red heart damage on the floor. It seems like it's a little bit more forgiving in Rebirth to get these deals with the devil, though. Then you just get, yeah, one angel or one goat head and your troubles are over. Synth oil for the damage upgrade. Super happy. I'm not going to take either of these, unfortunately. I've got to try for a key, right? Like, please get all four of these pots. It did, but it didn't give us anything. Oh man, there's six pots for a bomb there. I've got to try for it because we're missing so much on this floor right now. We're missing an item room and we're missing a shop with more than enough money to open it. We can't even access that shit, so we will go to our curse room. I don't know what we're gonna get out of it, but maybe something. Oh, that chest. I didn't get the more bombs. Oh, I should have used the the free bomb to blow up that chest in the middle. That could have changed everything. Well, that's a disappointment. Especially because we weren't able to really get a deal with the devil I feel strongly about. So, well, let's look on the bright side. We got a damage upgrade. We got tons of cash. All we need is keys. You remember the classic Beatles song? All you need is keys. Doop-a-doop-a-doop. Where'd you put your keys, babe? Where'd you put your keys? Anyway. I was never the life of the party when it came to rock band Beatles. That's just, it's not a joke. That's just my true-to-life, experiences. MTV True Life, I was not the most popular kid when it came to rock band Beatles. That should show you the kind of crew that I hung with in college, right? Tuesday night, what do you guys want to do? Rock band Beatles and a few craft beers? Fuck yeah, okay. Nothing has changed. Now, this floor, let's double in, double down. I'm a big gambler, too, as you can tell. We're going to double down on deals with the angel here. Please, give me a chance. I would like it. Give me Sacred Heart plus Technology 2. Our Technology 2 laser, I mean, it's doing fine. Could be better. Oh my god, why are we getting such good luck here? I mean, not that I'm complaining, but it's kind of ridiculous. We don't even have, like, a petrified poop or anything. There's our key. So we're going to talk about... Hey... Good to know that we have it, at least. We're going to talk about what we're going to do with this curse room, but we're not going to actually go to it yet. For reasons that I hope are kind of obvious by now. Please, I was really hoping an item room would be adjacent to it here, but actually, this room's not so bad. I really doubt these Diglets are going to get too close. And because they're not going to get too close, we're going to be able to hit them from far away and not really put ourselves in too much harm's way in the process. Now, it's not a guarantee that we'll get a deal with the angel crack here. We might get a deal with the devil if we play our cards right, so I'm hoping not to take any extra damage. Any damage that is not absolutely 100% necessary, that is. There's our item room. Okay, this could be big. So I don't really know how toxic blood is going to affect us here. I've never really seen a good use of anemia. But I'm happy to have it, you know? I'm happy to learn. I'm assuming that when we get hit, we drop blood that deals damage to enemies or something. Or when enemies die, they explode in like a cloud of blood that deals some damage. I mean, you can see the blood cloud spurts there. But I don't know if that's aesthetic or if it actually does damage, or maybe it's both. Joker? Two of spades. It's good. Would have been amazing on the last floor. For now, it's just good. Alright, well, we'll fight our boss. We're strong enough to beat whatever boss we come across here. I'm not worried about that. Mega Ma. Oh, it's been a while. Appear to be energy crystals. If we find the energy crystals, we'll find Dr. Wowie. I love reading all the comments about that impression, by the way, where people are like, it's so fucking stupid, but I still laugh every time. That's pretty much my, that's pretty much the value that I aspire to. Is that a tinted rock right there? I think it may be a tinted rock right there. It was a tinted rock right there. I wish I noticed that earlier, because I took some red heart damage that I feel pretty silly about now. No deal with the angel. We got a tears and shot speed up, which is like the last thing you need on a Technology 2 run. So I'm not really inspiring a ton of confidence right now. Probably. Should say I'm not really inspired with a ton of confidence, I guess, but let's use two of spades, then come in here. PhD, very good. You know what? We got the cash. Let's buy the ladder as well. We got I Can See Forever. That's our secret room sorted for us. There's one. Well, we could have saved two keys, but whatever. That's basically the money that we spent on the ladder already back. Now, mind you, that doesn't really matter because the ladder's pickup was kind of not determined by that. Can we pick up this penny in here now, by the way, because we have the ladder? Yes, we can. We're going to go to our curse room. It's going to cost us our spirit heart. Hey, shit happens. We also want to take a look for our second secret room, so I think it's worth it. I'm just listening for the sound now. It shouldn't be here. Shouldn't be here. Should be here, this room. No, okay. Here? Maybe there is no second secret room on this floor. It's been known to happen. Hey, okay. So Guppy's Collar means that if we get a deal with the devil on the next floor, we could maybe become Guppy, and Guppy Technology 2 is the stuff of dreams. Yeah, I don't think there's a second secret room. No, that's not true. It could be on the far left room here. The room just prior to the boss room. And it was. Alright. Sweet. That is actually really good. So this run's coming together. It's not crazy exciting yet, but we're only two Guppy items away from having a Technology 2 Guppy run, which is the stuff of legend in vanilla. And if we could get that, plus, like, I don't know, some stupid stuff like, Spoon... Oh, we didn't have I Can See Forever. So I'll tell you how my thought process went there. That was really bad, by the way. I'll put a bomb down and see if, we can get that golden chest to come out. And then it missed, and I was like, well, maybe we can get the secret room. No, Northern Line, don't be stupid. You can't get the secret room because you already have X-ray goggles. Then I remembered. No, I didn't. So, strangely enough, that sort of worked out. As of right now, how do I feel about this run? I'm happy with it. I like the damage from technology. The DPS isn't through the roof, but that's okay. Our money situation is great. Key situation has finally sorted itself out. I never want to know what I missed in those item rooms. I'm just kidding. I hope that if you guys are playing the seed and you manage to get some keys out of it, you'll let me know. Could have saved that poop for something a little bit more special, but whatever. But I think this run definitely has the capabilities to make it work. Any run where you got technology, I think you're only a couple items away from really having a winning run. It's no guarantee, but it's on the table. So that's Ouija board. This is pretty much what I asked for, so how can I complain about that? I believe the Ouija board will make it so that we can shoot over rocks. Would love the ability to fly. Hey, this is exactly where we want to be here. And with the ladder, we can come over here. No, not quite. Can we actually access this stuff with the ladder? Yeah, wait a minute. I'm an idiot. We can't access all of it, but we at least could get the bomb. How about in here? No greed. I kind of like this item. Hive mind. We don't have better... we don't have flies or spiders. That being said, we could have flies or spiders soon if we become Guppy. Oh, Dark One. Coming here to ruin my, yeah, my dream of beating this boss fight without taking damage, right? Thereby ruining my deal with the devil chance. You jerk. You consummate asshole. You uncouthed vagabond. Now, Dark One, I've gotten a little bit better at fighting. He is still a pain in the D, though. Don't really mind the darkness. I was born in the darkness, molded by it. I did not see... Tied until I was already a man. I was trying to make that like a corporate thing, which doesn't make any fucking sense. I didn't mean to pick up that spirit heart, by the way, because I'm intending to go to curse rooms if we find them. We're at 11 minutes. Here's the deal, right? I actually kind of love the idea of doing boss rush on this run, even though we're not that powerful. And that might sound silly, but boss rush gives you the choice of an item, so we can at least walk into the... What are we? I'm in Necropolis 1? Catacombs 2. It's gonna be a little tight, but if we do it, we can at least walk in there and see if there's an item we want. And if the items are shit, we can leave. We don't have to fight the enemies unless we pick up an item. But if the items are good enough, and they'd have to be pretty fucking great, we could justify it. Oh, Ouija board makes it so we can't shoot over the rocks. Still. I mean, it doesn't make it so that we can't, it just doesn't change that fact. Which is very unfortunate. We have PhD. We have to do this, then. Oh, we have the ladder. Okay. Just, that was the bomb tax. Don't worry about it. Health up. Fudge, yeah. I can see forever. We'll use it on the next floor because we've already found a secret room on this floor. It'll mean probably skipping the secret room on this floor. The second secret room, I should say, but... No, where's the... That's not a big deal. Now, the arcade, if there's a demon judgment, I'll go crazy on that. I doubt there will be, though. But there could be. You never know. Well, we got a nickel for a penny. That's a pretty good trade. You know, I'll give you like... I'll play you five times. That's two, three, four, and... Oh, ho, ho. Lucky us. Even more HP. Now, we're going to be like 13 minutes, maybe 13:30 by the time we get down to the next floor. It's going to have to be... Ugh, it's going to have to be two mighty quick floors. We could do it, and I think we could do it without even sacrificing... item rooms or shops. But it's going to be a little tight. Because we have to beat Mom in that time span as well. The Mom fight could take a minute here. And we only lost half of one of those spirit hearts. That's not so bad. Alright. We're a little bit ahead of the curve according to that clock. Not by much though. Curse of the Unknown means we can't see our HP. Honestly, not that big of a deal. Now the easiest way, it might seem like going fast is the fastest way to get this done, but I think the easiest way to do this is actually just make sure that we're attacking as many enemies at the same time as we can. The more enemies we attack simultaneously, the faster the rooms will end, and I think our movement speed is more important, or is less important than the speed at which we kill enemies. Okay, greed fight, I don't mind. I wish that our Ouija board actually worked with technology. The fact that it doesn't is an endless source of sadness for me. But I've grown accustomed to it. I don't like this greed fight right now. Take advantage of the fact that Cube of Meat was right in front of me for a second there and then I blew it. That's okay. It's money, at least. I know there's a little bit more back there. I just wanted to pick this up first. High Priestess. This should be easy. I'm going to use Yumheart. I can't see our HP, but I assume that we were out of Spirit Hearts by then. We did get hit like 5 times. There's our item room. This is potentially big. Oh, money equals power. Okay. This is crazy big for us. I know there's a pill there. With PhD, that's something I'm obviously very interested in. But I'm super excited that we just got like 1.72, basically, damage upgrade as a result of... 1.74. No, wait. 1.64 damage upgrade as a result of this. You know, okay, we don't have full health. We can tell that just by an ambient cue. Ambient cue is also my name in the EDM community. Now we must have full health because we weren't able to get into the mob trap room before, but we weren't able to pick up that red heart immediately after. So we're at full red heart health. So if we get hit, it's safe for us to use Yumheart. Good to know. Just use your divination skills here. Is this worth it? I think so. Turns out the answer was... Yeah, okay, bomb for a key is not horrible here. Is key for a bomb? Good trade? I don't know. Now that the mystery's gone, it doesn't feel as exciting anymore. Here's our shop. This is a big one. Immediately after this, we will bum rush the boss. That was really bad. The Bible. No, it's not good enough, though. The pill, though. Speed up. Oh, it's good. It's good enough. Now, I'm spending money even though we have money equals power. That might not be the best play in the world. It's okay, though. Does High Priestess work against Mom? 15 minutes. Yeah, we're doing all right. I don't know. We might use High Priestess against this boss to give us a better chance of getting a deal with the devil for not taking damage. We made it, and we never have to go through there again. And thanks to I Can See Forever, we can find this room over here. Almost got trapped on that rock. That would have been terrible. Okay, nothing special. It does something to our tears. You know what? I'm just gonna take a second here. It's a little bit of a waste of time, but at least we get to keep High Priestess. What do you got for me? Who are we fighting? The Bloat. High Priestess. Fuck you, Bloat. I'm not gonna let you ruin my chances at a deal with the devil here. Safe place for the Bloat is directly behind him. I blew it. That was me that time. I blew it. Yep, that was not good. Our HP could be in a terrible spot right now, actually. Now we just gotta hope we get a good item from him. Coat hanger. That's, like, not that good when you have technology. Okay, down to the next floor. We're ahead of the curve still. Hey, our HP was actually not as bad as I thought it was. And Depths 2 should be faster than Necropolis. Necropolis still tricky. Still a tricky kind of thing going on there. I think we can... Here's the thing. If there's a great item on our boss rush room, I think we can justify doing it. If there's not, then we just leave. Which is not so bad. Well, you know. come down here, and we might as well just use this right away. Oh, this is great. I can see forever, at least, is, you know, it's worth having. And our yum heart was ready right away. Yeah, there's our secret room. And it gives us a decent amount of money, which is great for money equals power. Not super easy to curve technology shots here, but oh, that's puberty. We'll take it with us. It doesn't do shit, I think, but it's okay. Relatively easy enemies here. So what are we looking for? Just item room, shop, boss room. Anything else that is non-compulsory, we're going to ignore because we are getting a little tight on time here. 18 minutes. I put that down, but I'm going to leave. I don't think I'm actually going to give Judgment my hard-earned cash because it actually is damage and it takes time. That's just two big knocks there. Touched your mama's two big knocks last night. Somehow it didn't take damage right there. Somehow. A little faster, please. I can afford to skip our shop, maybe? I really don't want to skip our item room. Oh, crap. What do you think, guys? 1830? I'd say we need a full minute to beat Mom. Not loving that. Okay, you know what? I say we don't need a full minute to beat Mom. I say we need 45 seconds. So let's be fast here. This could end up being, like, meaningless, by the way. I really wanted this to not be a dead end. Fuck it. I'm gonna go for it. This might end up being a catastrophic decision. Straight up. It might end up being terrible. But it's possible we can get the ability to teleport out of the fight. And, out of the room, I should say. And I like the cleverness of this. Let's put it that way. Is it going to end up being the right decision? That's not easy to say. I'm going to keep the timer up. 1920, so we got 40 seconds. If the foot comes down and like the body parts stay active a little longer, that shouldn't be that tough to do. Like, that was a really nice little period for us there. And anytime we can damage multiple things at once, we got to take that. We got to take them up on that offer. Oh, this is actually looking very close. I don't think we're going to be able to do it. Kind of amazingly. Start throwing some bombs down here. We got 10 seconds? No, we're not going to do it. We're not going to get a deal with the devil either. Oh, I threw it all away for nothing. Come on. Ah, we're like 3 seconds short. If I hadn't gone to that extra room, we totally would have had time. That's so shitty. Yeah, we lost our chance. So we get the negative. Beautiful. And I threw away our chance at that last item room and shop. Bad play. But I was only off by like 9 fucking seconds. What do you want me to say? Sorry. There might not have even been anything great in that boss trap or in the boss rush room, but still, man. We got the worst of all possible worlds there. No boss rush room. So not even any choice. Missed out on our item room and our shop. Ugh, all because of a stupid 10 second cumulative difference. If I just maybe didn't buy those things at our last shop, we might have had just enough damage to speed our fight up by that much. I don't know. I'm not gonna harp on it too much because this run is still pretty good. But it is disappointing. I was looking forward to doing a clever play for once. There goes our spirit heart, not very smart. This game is bright now. This is what happens when you have the gamma cranked up to like 1,000. Yeah, we'll just move along here. We've discovered 2 dead ends already, which is pretty nice. Narrows it down a little bit. It actually might not speed up our rate at which we actually find the boss, but it makes me think that we're doing it, so it's good. Really, the star of this run right now is technology too. Were it not for that item, we'd be in a bit of a tricky spot. Yeah, I mean, 3 red chests is a pretty good haul for a mob trap room. And we do have 1 guppy item, so yeah, we'll end up doing it. I just didn't want to put ourselves in a difficult position where maybe I end up taking damage and ruining a good deal with the devil chance or something. But I guess, as long as we don't take damage against the boss, that puts us in a better position. But we're probably going to take damage against the boss. Okay, this went pretty well. We got a spirit heart at least, which protects us. I mean, it doesn't give us the guppy item we asked for, but it protects us against bosses that we'll be facing like right now. And it protects us against bosses that we'll be facing in the boss room. I don't really care which boss we face, honestly. I think we can handle most of them. Not the adversary, preferably. Oh, wow. Good luck. Hopefully a red chest in there that gives us, like, Guppy's, not 9 lives. Guppy's not 9 lives. That's my favorite Guppy item now. If we can get anything that Guppy has except for 9 lives, that would do it. Alright, so we're like 80% of the way through this one now, and we're going pretty quickly here. If only we could guarantee ourselves a fight against Chubb on every room. Excuse me? What do you mean I can't go into the fucking secret room? What do you mean I can't go into this? Does it require 2 bombs? Okay, sure. That makes sense. I'm not salty about that at all. Because we have like an unlimited number of bombs, so it's not really that big of a deal. Ba with the ba there, but I'm not sure if I want to ba with the ba there, to be honest with you. Bad damage. There goes our spirit heart, but we earned that spirit heart. Just give me the quarter or something, bro. I need some more damage bonuses. I need more allowance. Why? Because I do. Yeah, that's good. Gives us a use for Yum Heart finally as well. Can we beat Isaac on raw HP? Yeah, I think it's possible. Anything's possible if you put your mind to it. Apparently. That's what my guidance counselor tells me. Did your school have a nurse? I always thought that was something that was made up. Wow. I always thought that was something that was made up in fiction. High school nurse. What do you need a nurse for in your high school? What, do you go to fucking the School of Hard Knocks literally? Like, you got a lot of brain injuries that need treated? What do you get? Oh, I have a stomach ache. Go home. You know? Oh, I got a headache. Here's some Tylenol. You don't need a nurse for that. Probably, maybe legally you do. I don't know. We didn't have a nurse in our high school. We had the principal. You got a headache? Fucking do your homework. Who cares? You call me a piece of shit, go see the principal. That's how our school went down. One day, dude put his head through one of those like reinforced glass windows, had to go to the hospital. If only we had a school nurse, right? What was she gonna do? Perform a life-saving fucking tracheotomy or something? No, you got the nurse would. Can she call the hospital? I shouldn't say she, but it's usually the nurse is portrayed as a female. Is she gonna call the hospital any faster than anybody else? Yeah, you could still 3 numbers, man, whether you've got a nursing degree or not. We didn't have a school nurse. That's the message I'm trying to send here. Where the fuck is our boss room? Oh, I'm still a little salty about that boss rush mode not working out fantastically. It's okay. You know, life goes on. And we've got a decent run with money equals power technology too here. We did miss out on some synergies though. How sweet would Spoon Bender have been? Answer, pretty flippin' sweet. Now we can at least kill this guy. Can't get across to kill the other one until now. And I'm gonna try to hang out like near the top because I'm pretty sure at the top, his attack, oh, it still reached me. So I took damage against Mr. Fred because I was trying to prove a point. I am now the king of the idiots. So I would kiss our deal with the devil attempt goodbye. But that's okay. Mr. Fred could still give us a useful item. If there is a benevolent force in the universe, Mr. Fred will pay out like crazy with the pentagram. With magic mush. Oh, that was dumb. Fuck Squeezy. I don't need any more tears upgrades. Why am I just tanking this damage? Like, not very proud of myself right now. What do you got for me, dog? You're straight up dead, so you might as well just, like, you know, save us both the trouble here. It's an HP upgrade, and no deal with the devil, which I knew going in, but still, it's a little bit frustrating. We have the chance to make this run amazing. I'm interested to know how the seed worked out for other people, because I do think I've kind of thrown it here a little bit. I think we're still going to beat Isaac, but I think it's a run that had the potential to be OP. And instead, it just is. Just good enough. I don't like dodging through those guys for that exact reason that you just saw. Man, if we had like Humbling Bundle or Contract from Below on this run, that would be so good. I'll use a bomb here. Golden Chest gave me a key in return. I see you've got a sense of humor of game. Well, get ready for this shit. Any minute now. They're starting to die. Life's good. You know, I would deal with that room 15 times if you want me to. Go ahead. I chose a very specific number because I did rigorous analysis. You think I didn't? You think I'm the kind of guy who would say 15 times just off the top of his head without performing a series of empirical tests? There was stoichiometry involved, motherfucker. We were doing a lot of titrations. Oh, jeez, I didn't think there were as many of you left as there actually are. Thanks for the live bomb. They don't make cards for that anymore. Thanks for the live bomb. I hope they never made cards for that. But you know them with their card making. Emperor? Justice is okay. That one penny might make all the difference, man. It's an extra 0.04 damage. Nothing to sneeze at. Alright, well this is where we can... Well, we can gamble some red hearts away. Do we want to gamble them away on Demon Judgment, though? Or do we want to gamble them away on the Blood Bank? Or do we want to gamble them away at all? Finally, we got a trinket. Come on, though. The stars? Ugh. I'm gonna play this. I'm gonna try to get out of this little cubbyhole I've painted myself into. Even though it is gonna cost us some damage in the process, it's not gonna cost us very much. You fudger. Okay. 47. The keys are meaningless. I'm gonna blow this thing up, get some red hearts back. Thank you. That's one play. Ah, okay. Good. I'm gonna blow you up, too. No red hearts. Oh, Emperor card. Okay, that's pretty good. Our other one there was the stars. Not so valuable. I'm still thinking we've got some good ability here. I'm just gonna use a key to grab this. We've got some good ability to gamble on this Demon Judgment. I don't necessarily want to do it right now. But I'm gonna, because I have no willpower. Okay, we have to not. We can't just keep that up forever. Could be a secret room here. Is a secret room there? We'll blow this up. I don't want to give up too much money is the thing. Speed up, okay. We've already given up like 0.4 damage, which is not that much, but it makes a difference. Please don't chase me down. Excuse me, sir. I'm gonna have to ask you politely to stop. It's very rude of you. No more chasing, please. And this is where I eat shit for saying Dingle's easy, right? I don't think so. Dingle's still kind of eating crap on this one. Eating poop. Crap is another euphemism for poop that's maybe a little bit more kid-friendly. Just a word to the wise for all you parents out there. If we just kind of, go here, do these guys eat shit forever? Yeah. Yeah, they kind of do. Where's my full health pill? I have PhD. I've earned it. If this room is Isaac's bedroom, we're very lucky. It's a 1. I think 1 is just forget me now. Oh, why dodge right into it? What am I going to do with a forget me now? Play through the womb 2 again? That doesn't seem like a good idea to me. Starting to regret my decision to blow up everything that could have given me red hearts for money. But my thinking was that it would remove the temptation to play them. But it hasn't really done that. It just makes me feel bad about not having any red hearts. I really thought we'd get more dropped randomly. Ah, okay, that's a start. Oh, shit. I don't like this room. Keep it going. Keep it going. Oh, no! What do you think, guys? Look for second secret rooms? Not a bad idea. Not a bad idea at all. We don't have that many bombs, though. Oh, we did it. Oh, it's beautiful. Okay. Have we learned our lesson? Ooh, I really want to play the Demon Judgment. I'm gonna play him like three times. I'm just gonna play him three times. That's three hearts. We can afford three hearts, maybe. Probably can't. It might kill us. But think of the items. Oh, is this the stupidest idea of all time? I've got a new lease on life. One time. Fish head. Two times. Oh, coin purse. This is it. Health up. Yes, please. I can see forever. Not this floor. Yes, this floor, actually. Because we're going to take something else on the next floor. That was so not worth it. Emperor card. Let's take Pinky Eye. I think the poison damage is well more worth it for us. All right, that was not worth it. Even at the end, it was not worth it. But it was interesting. I'm not going to use that forget-me-now. Do we know it's the tower? No, thank you. No, thank you. Now remember, going up to the cathedral next. We're not going to Shoal. Let's do it. Pinky Eye with the technology 2 poison damage. My thinking is just that we're going to have like a lot of... Basically, the enemy's going to be poisoned at all times as a result of the fact that technology 2 fires like 15 times per second or something stupid like that. And with the damage over time, that should allow us to kill Mom a lot faster. Thank you, Cube of Meat, for blocking that shot. Now, there's enemies on the screen. I don't like that so much. This is good, though. We're doing damage very, very slowly to Mom's heart. I don't enjoy that so much. Chubb is dead, though. What are you doing up there? Yeah, you're not playing by the rules. Mom's heart. Good, 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 good. This is less good. Okay. I mean, the whole crux of this run was Technology 2 being able to consistently do damage to you. I'll be straight with you. I actually think we're kind of screwed for Isaac. Oh, you're going that way this time, are you? All right, well, it's going to mostly be poison damage, I think, that's going to get you. Oh, I went the wrong way. Don't laugh at me. Don't call me names. Don't get your pleasure from my pain. At least we got our red heart back. We gotta beat Isaac without getting hit like 6 times. It's possible. I don't know if it's likely though. We might as well, let's check here for like a secret room. And we're gonna see if this room's easy. This room seems like we're gonna take damage, so I'm getting out. I thought about it. I was like, we'll go through these rooms to see if we can get more consumables or something like that. Oh, crap. Okay, this is gonna be a long, drawn-out battle here. As you can see, we're not really doing very much damage to Isaac right now. Taking off about 10% of his HP. Now, we haven't been hit, so that's exciting. Oh, there we go. Had to happen at some point. The patterns are workable. Oh, why just stand still? Why just stand still there? That's good. Where do the beams go? Where do the beams go? Just around him? That's not so bad. Where do the beams go? Oh, maybe I should have finished that room so I could get a Yum Heart charge. We're looking dangerously close. No, stop shooting. Oh, fudge this. Okay, we're safe in the corners. Remember that always. And remember me always, even if we lose. Oh my god. Okay, okay. No, no, you don't understand. Run away. Oh, snap. Okay, stay in the corners. That would... No, not that corner! No, 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 you don't understand. Back the fudge up, mister. Oh, jeez. Oh, he's too fast. This corner, this corner. Oh, we did it, okay. Stay away. This is perfect. We got a brief period to do some damage. Never come close to me. You're not welcome in my house anymore. I do not invite you in. This corner, this corner, this corner. Yes, that corner. Oh, we might do it. Nope. Okay, we faked him out. Good stuff. He's almost dead. This corner. We're safe. Oh, Jesus Christ, we're safe. Okay. He's dead. I think we got him. Oh, it's so close. I really thought we were actually closer to finishing than we actually are. We did it. We did it. Well, let's be honest. First off, I'm so happy we unlocked the relic. But secondly, I probably made that run harder on myself than I needed to. Oh, did I even look at the seed that time? I might have forgotten to look at the seed. Oh well. In any case, that's a bummer at the end, but especially as like, what are you guys doing on the seed that I'd be interested to know? Anyway, maybe I did, maybe I didn't. If I didn't, remind me on Twitter what the seed is and I'll put it in the video description. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed that run. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. Next run, we probably gotta do a Judas run and get a cathedral or a lamb kill. But for now, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.